probably we should be going now.
The summer counteroffensive started in the Berdansk direction. At its forefront, the 37th Marine Brigade. Their first victory was the liberation of Neskuchne. Five other settlements followed. This section of the front line holds immense strategic significance, as Russia's crucial land route to the occupied territories of Crimea passes through here.
This exact unit, they've been working since 4 a.m., meaning that they woke up at 3. And now they're recharging their ammo, and they will come back to shoot more. I mean, it's very hard work. Each shell weighs about 6 kilograms. While we've been here waiting for the howitzer to get loaded, we've heard several incoming shots with very characteristic whistling sound. Several of them, they didn't explode, luckily for us, but the incoming shots are getting closer and closer, so as soon as the car is ready, we'll be heading off.
Typically, artillery positions are 15 to 20 kilometers behind the point of contact. However, today is an exception, as we're heading to a position that's remarkably close, just 6 kilometers away from the zero line. It's quite risky, considering the size of the equipment.
So the beast behind my back is the world's most popular self-propelled howitzer, M109. This one is the Italian-made version, which Italy kindly presented to Ukraine. And the soldiers jokingly call it the grandmother of the paladin.
While the commander waits for coordinates, the crew prepares. They're winding the detonators to the shells and aiming the howitzer at the surroundings via the deep compass. This model doesn't have a built-in GPS system, so the precision of targeting depends solely on the deep compass operator's skills.
This is our Soviet-made deep compass. My great-grandfathers used to work with it. The shot is fired from here. This is the device that we use for aiming. We choose how we work depending on the target. Either we orient against the dip compass, or we simply choose the direction of the target. And only then, at the command of the officer, we load, aim, check, and fire.
Immediately after the shot has been fired, the soldiers rush to mask the howitzer. They know within moments Russia will strike back. They also know that without the artillery fire, the infantry has no chance of breaking through Russian fortified defense lines. In these critical moments, there is no room for fear or fatigue.
Just a second ago, there was another incoming hit. Probably we should be going now.